You're listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network, now the largest new media platform on the web and your number one source for after-show entertainment. The AfterBuzz Studios in Los Angeles, California, presented by Maria Menounos and streaming live thanks to Akamai Technologies. This is AfterBuzz TV's Dad's After Show. We'll break down tonight's episode and get you all the latest news and gossip. And now, another post-game wrap-up show for your favorite TV show. It's AfterBuzz TV's Dad's After Show.
That's right. Hey guys, what's up? This is the Dad's After Show at AfterBuzz TV. We are doing season 1, episode 7, and we're still dancing. It's foul play.
Lane Grace.
Hey, and we've got Vanessa Lachey.
Hey.
What's up? She came in, you guys. We bring it to you every week. Did we not promise you that we were bringing you guests? Hi, Seth Green and Vanessa Lachey.
Boom.
I let Seth get your guys' cherry. Bam. And now I'm the icing, right?
That's right. She's the icing.
And we also had John Viner.
And John Viner.
Oh, that's right.
Goodness
gracious. But he was a call-in, so he wasn't actually here.
Lame.
So we're bringing Vanessa Lachey for you tonight. I am your host, Lauren Leonelli. On the panel, we have...
I am Mr. Kevin John. So happy to be here.
And I'm Jenifer Golden. Also really happy.
Holla! Okay, yep. So tonight we are going to run down the episode, which Vanessa had a huge, amazing, funny, hysterical part.
Yes.
And then we're going to, you know, talk, ask questions, and interview.
And get the down low, low down.
Is this Phil...
if we have, so serious. I still feel like we have to be gangster now that because we just had that intro.
Yeah, no.
No,
we are.
No, yeah, you,
we're
of course.
A gang.
Yeah, you can
that's
be.
Oh, we are. You guys actually are a gang. You even have colors.
Yeah, you're
black and yellow.
Black and yellow, black and yellow, black
that
and yellow,
be our
black
song.
And yellow. Phil, if we have callers, are they 424-256-1729 in the studio?
Yes.
Okay. So if you have a question for Miss Vanessa Lachey, you can call 424-256-1729. You can tweet us and
oh, great.
Ask
now there's pressure.
No, there's no pressure.
Because if they don't call or tweet, what does that say?
Nothing.
About me?
It's fine.
They
well,
never
to be
call.
Fair,
people
we
don't care.
One of the biggest things is we've switched the show up so many times in terms of timing.
That's right.
We're on Thursdays, we're on Fridays, we're on Tuesdays,
guys,
we're on
every call day. In, ask questions, please.
Please.
Even if you were watching a different show at this time, just call us.
Sometimes happens.
We've had callers for other shows.
I'll patch in the Bad Girls Clubs.
Yes!
She can talk to anybody.
Yeah.
I will talk to a fly on the wall.
It's true.
And Vanessa said she will answer any question.
Anything.
Any question.
Nothing is off the books. Only for AfterBuzz TV.
Oh, see?
Look
exclusive.
At that.
Exclusive.
That's
exclusive. Exclusive. Exclusive.
Bam.
Exclusive.
Exclusive.
All right. So let's start talking about foul play. I've been dying for this episode because I knew it was coming, and I was just, first of all, I, you know, love the theater, so I loved the little theater jokes and all of that, but we had two things going on. We've got, you know, David and the bedbugs, and Eli's getting all upset about it, and then Camila in the play, which I'm not biased, but that was my favorite part of the episode.
thanks.
So, let's talk about the bedbugs really quick. We kind of discover that, you know, I think Edna comes in, and she's like, right.
Well, you know, we try to make the show as relatable as we can to everyday life, and bedbugs
is an everyday
affect
life problem.
Us all.
They do.
So why not laugh about it?
Why not?
Yes. What I love about the show is there's two lives, the life of Giovanni's character, Warner, my husband, and the life of Seth Green's character, Eli, my husband's friend and business partner, and it's kind of how they all intertwine with their dads involved. It's brilliant writing, and I give so much credit to the guys, the crazy minds behind Family Guy and Ted, Alex Sulkin, Wellesley Wild, and Seth MacFarlane.
Yes.
So you can't go wrong with that. Literally, when we get a script, I'm amazed, and I'm so sad that sometimes we have to cut it down because of timing. Because it's a half-hour show and we can only do 18 minutes. But
we feel like that, though, when we're watching, to interject for a second. Like, there's so much more. We know you guys go further.
So much more.
And with the improv that happens,
between
which you'll tell us about.
Between timing and standards and practices, a lot of it doesn't make the air. You were at a taping, Jen, and you saw, I mean, it's a, you know, 18-minute show, but it lasts. The taping is, like, 4 to 5 hours.
Yeah. Well,
Because I saw you hanging out in the corner with your phone mm-hmm. and your girlfriend.
I was there.
And your glass of wine.
My several glasses of wine. That's right. You guys were really
funny. Literally, before I knew Jen, I'm like, who's the hot girl hanging out on set?
Jen the Jew, yeah. Everybody. Jen the Jew.
Yeah, she was smoking hot and totally like trying to sneak in on the set. And I'm kidding.
Actually, I was really trying to sneak.
She was very incognito and sweet.
I really wanted to watch The Magician.
We have a crowd warmer.
Yeah. Okay, tell us about
because, this guy. You know, well, first of all, what I love, again, about the show is, and I love this show, so please slap me if I just talk about homies.
Oh, we're fans. I have to say something. We are here because we are super fans of the show,
yay!
And everybody watching is tuning in because they watch the show, and then they're like, yay! We want more, so go on.
What I do love is Seth MacFarlane is such an old soul. As a person, he loves, you know, the Frank Sinatra era of music. He loves orchestra. He loves things that are true, that are real, that are from the heart. And things that he remembers in his childhood are multicam sitcoms with live studio audiences. He doesn't believe in a laugh track. He, in fact, made a point to say, guys, we need to let this be known. So at the beginning of every show, you hear one of the seven of us say, Dad's is recorded in front of a live studio audience.
Like the good old days.
Like the good old days, because we literally, you saw Jen, we yeah. have a crowd that comes in, they get there at 4, we give them pizza and sugar and sodas. And we have a crowd warmer. Sometimes he does tricks. Sometimes he raps. He gets people involved.
He raps.
There was like yeah. a bachelorette thing going on.
Sometimes they do improv. Yeah. I mean, you have to keep, because at the end of the day, they're there for 4 or 5 hours. And when they're still laughing at the end of the show, you know you've got a great show. But beyond that, I give a lot of credit to this guy because they've been sitting in one seat for four yeah. or 5 hours watching the same scene, sometimes over and over. And we like to give back to the crowd by changing it up with the script. Sometimes we add things in that will never make air, but we know they're going to love. And Seth Green is so good about giving back to the audience. You would think that he'd want to be focused on, but he's such a seasoned veteran at this that he can actually play around with the audience and come right back and be in character, play around with the audience and come back and be into character. Whereas I'm kind of a nervous wreck because my scenes are with Giovanni Ribisi and Martin Mull.
Yeah,
so,
but let's just say something about that for a second. And that, you know, I've watched you and I think that you're very, very natural. And I think
you.
That it's also just a talent that, you know, you have good timing and you're very natural. But I think it helps because we've seen this girl since, 1998 is when we first saw you, Miss Teen USA.
Oh, gosh.
And then MTV. So I feel like half the battle is being comfortable in front of a live studio audience, and you've got that down.
Thank you. It's interesting because I remember right when we came and did the pilot in April this year, April 20th, actually.
420.
420 for all those smokeheads that are listening.
Thanks, Kevin.
Is that where you were going with that? I was like, what is she talking about?
Exactly. I just...
We're the weed trendsetters.
Apparently, we're the potheads on this half over here, so we understood that. But
we don't know what you guys are talking about.
No. Like, of that course man. Not.
But it was around that time because I remember it was also Peter's birthday. Anyways, I'm getting off tangent here.
Pop brownies. That's all I have to say. Yeah, that was a good
was
episode.
Pop brownie
by the way.
Episode. What was my point? So with Seth, I remember.
And we digress.
I remember telling him, like, you guys, I'm so. It's not that I was nervous, but I said, I'm really grateful for this opportunity. I'm the newbie here, you know? Martin Mull did the math, and he had been on over 35 multicam sitcoms. Seth and Giovanni have been on television since before they were 10. So, I mean, I think they met in a Fruit Loops commercial.
They really?
Oh,
that's
a good story. Giovanni will kill me, but you have to Google the two of them in the Fruit Loops commercial. I know you've seen it. It's where he pulls the mask off and he has the haunted dream. It's
I haven't.
Hilarious.
Maybe it'll ring a bell.
It'll ring a bell.
Have you seen it?
And then
I have not seen it. It'd be awesome if we can pull up.
I guarantee you, you've seen it. And then Brenda Song, you guys know, Disney yeah. princess, and she was 6 years old.
Wait, what? Disney
yeah.
princess?
Yeah, Sweet Life.
Sweet Life, Zack and Cody.
Zack and Cody.
Is her last thing, but she's been
I thought
on
you were going to tell me she was Mulan, and I was going to say, oh my God, yes, she was.
No, not an actual Jen. Disney princess.
Wait, just saying the best line that she had tonight was Asian. And then they're like, why are you staying here? And she's like, Asian.
Yeah. And then they were Jewish.
Right. Oh, so good.
I love when they do
so
that.
So funny. So I remember saying that I was just nervous being around all these veterans. And, you know, Peter Riegert, Animal House.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. That's all I have to say. That was his first movie. That was his first break. Nuts. And then from then, crazy. He's done amazing things.
Crazy.
Tunita has been on television for decades.
We love her.
So funny.
That's Edna, right?
She needs to come in. She'll totally rock your world. But I remember telling Seth Green this, and he was like, you know what, Vanessa, you've done TRL with a live audience. He's like, that's an element that some actors don't actually get to experience and aren't comfortable with. And I was like, oh, you're right. I actually don't even think about them, don't see them. I feel them because that's part of the ride. I feel the laughter and I feel the positive affirmation, or vice versa. You feel when the joke just dies and you're like,
you switch it up.
Is this thing on?
Yeah.
Did they hear me?
But that's what I'm saying, though, V. I feel like that works so much in your favor to have that not get in your head about that.
Yeah.
Where most people, that would be the one thing that would make them nervous, throw them off. Because we all know, I mean, we've all dabbled our feet in the acting world a little, right? Yes.
What?
Guys, let's hear.
Theater majors?
I was a theater major in college, so I lived on the stage.
Oh.
But I was in Fiddler on the Roof, of course.
Give me a line.
That's so fitting.
Shalom.
But what I'm saying is that, you know how many things you have to think about while acting natural, which is fitting for this episode. But yeah. I feel like, you know, you've got to be on this mark and make sure you're turned the right way. And there's so many things happening that if you can just take like some of those things out of the equation and not let them get to you, that's why I feel like you're so natural.
Thank you. I feel uncomfortable because you're totally like just like giving me compliments.
No, stop it. It's true.
We can say the opposite if you wanted us to.
Exactly.
Stop it, Lauren. Go on.
No, but
it's so funny because go ahead.
No, I was just going to say, you know, I can see how much the audience there, and Seth even talked about that, how you get such an adrenaline from them when you're out there. Have you ever had just a crazy moment with the audience where you may have had some audience members that are a little too overzealous? Or
no, but there's always, it's so funny, I can pinpoint in every group, every Tuesday we tape at 4 o'clock, I can pinpoint the one that's...
Oh, God.
There's always one guy. Sometimes it's a woman.
That's just over the top.
You just hear.
And you're like.
That's
like
them.
A creepy, wicked clown laugh right there.
You hear them over.
And that doesn't take you out?
I can hear it. It actually, it kind of is a little endearing. And thank goodness my character isn't Brenda's, who has to be so, you know, deadpan the whole time. It's actually really cute. Speaking of this episode, in the movie when they're in the theater, scene where Giovanni says, why are we so early? And Martin says, I want to marvel at the curtain. It's actually before Seth, it's after Seth says, don't do the vagina and the popcorn trick. And I don't know if you noticed that Brenda smiles.
Yeah.
She totally was breaking there.
I thought they might have broken too when they were like on a date at the office.
She broke she broke there a little too. And it was cute because I was talking to the editor and he says, I love it when you break because it makes you very real. It's genuine. I mean, genuinely. Our breaking is we literally have to stop. We're hunched over. We're laughing. Tears are coming out.
Right.
Makeup comes back out for touch up. So for her to hold it and go,
yeah, that was funnier. Cute. That was cute.
And just give a smile.
As audience members, we like seeing that and feeling like you guys are friends and you have fun together. We like feeling like we're in on it a little
bit.
Right.
Yeah.
We're like, oh look.
Because that's the feeling the audience there really gets, the live audience, but then the people that are watching get to see every now and then.
Yeah.
Because the audience obviously sees us mess up. mess up bad.
But they like that though. It makes it real.
Love it.
It humanizes
exactly.
The whole experience. And it's like, it's fun. That's funny. Who doesn't like at the end of the movie when you're sitting there and the blooper reels
those
come up,
best.
You're like getting out of your seat and then you're like, oh.
Yeah.
You like,
it
like,
was
yeah.
so funny. We had Ernie Hudson on an episode we just filmed last week. And I don't know if you guys know, Ernie Hudson was in Ghostbusters.
Mm-hmm.
He was one of the Ghostbusters. And so Martin Mull comes out and in the scene he goes, sir, does anyone ever tell you you look like the African-American Ghostbuster? And Ernie kept it in because he didn't tell Ernie he was going to do it.
Of course not.
Kept it in, came out, walked out the door, and then just died laughing. And, guys, and then they played the music. The audience went crazy. Ernie got on the mic. He's like, I love y'all. Thank you so much. Because, you know, that's a big point in his career.
Yeah.
And I said, that's great. And then one of the producers goes, it's just for the audience.
I'm like, oh, that it makes it good. Because
that would have been funny on TV. But
it would have been funny. But, you know, there's so much stuff that I'm sure. And we all know this, and we all talk about this constantly, that we're fans of Ted and Family Guy, and there's just certain things that this particular venue cannot get away with. So we know what must go on behind the scenes or that doesn't make it to air because...
I'm even in shock sometimes. Like, I'll watch the episode, and I'm like, oh, they cut that. You know what I mean?
Yeah, you have to be,
because I know what they did, or it could be either timing. Mm-hmm. Did you guys see Oldfinger
when he had the prosthetic exam? Yes. Oh.
The scene where it's brilliant. The scene where Giovanni is actually getting the exam and he's and the tear.
Yeah.
It was 2 minutes and 23 seconds.
I swear I saw a tear there.
Yeah. It was a tear.
Okay.
It was the longest take. It was a single take.
Yeah.
It didn't cut. And I'm like, there's no way they're gonna use that. They ended up using it in the show, but because they used it, they had to cut 4 other scenes down
just for that,
to use that, because it was so brilliant. I mean, literally,
the tear was.
But can you imagine when it's like, when it's like Emmy nomination Giovanni Ribisi for Oldfinger in the prostate exam, and then they actually show the
and then they show the tear. I swear I saw a tear there.
He did.
No, that, you know what? It was worth it though, because
he's so amazing.
It was magical.
I still can't believe I every day get to act beside Giovanni Ribisi. And I mean, this is the ultimate learning ground for me, and I am just taking it in like a kid in a candy store.
I'm sure. Like, all these actors are like amazing. I mean,
and they're willing to give constructive criticism, and I am so willing to take it. They're like, Vanessa, try this. Yes. Okay. Wait. Tell me exactly how to say that.
But you hold your own. Again, I'm not just saying this because you're here, but like, you don't. I mean, I know you feel like you're out of place or not on the level with them, or just by what you're saying, but it's so untrue. Like, everybody on the show is, I think, well, they all contribute their own special little things, but nobody feels like, oh, how'd that person sneak in there? No. You know what I mean?
When we were watching it tonight, we were those loud laughers alone, though, in a room. Yeah. And it was like awkward, because I was like, if there's only the two of us, we know it's us.
And
exactly.
And there are people outside that probably hear us like cackling in here. You were hysterical.
Thank you. Next week's is even funnier. I'm just going to say that for the first time next week, they let me do physical comedy.
Okay, because
there was a lot tonight.
Yeah,
there was a lot of that. But even next week, I'm in virtual tennis.
Oh,
I mean, bleep goes down.
I hope you win.
Bleep goes down.
Oh, I'm sure it does. I'm sure it does. Okay, so we start off back to the episode. This is all
fantastic.
Wait, what are we talking about? So we see David come in. We see, actually, I think this is introduced to us because Edna comes in and is like, you're disgusting.
The bed bugs, right. Yeah. And then they move in to the office, because Eli's apartment is actually in the office building.
And we've talked about that before. We weren't exactly sure where it was in relation, but we get now that he's like above, and mm-hmm. you guys are close.
Yeah. Yeah. And we're in the Bay Area.
Woo-woo. That's where I'm from. Holla. So, you know, we're kind of dealing with, you know, this bed bug situation, which everyone's, you know, grossed out by. And of course, Eli, there's always something. There's always something that these dads are doing that is
making their son's life live in hell.
Exactly. You know? And this one I thought was very interesting and specific to go the bed bugs route, because you could just make it, you know, they're annoying that they're there, but I like that they went.
But the fact that he said he got them from the most unusual things, and I love when we were cracking up and they're like, oh, well, when I took a nap without my shirt on that park bench next to a homeless person.
Why would you do that?
Who would do it? Yeah.
And he asked that. I'm glad that
I'm a different person when I leave the
house. But I love that Eli was like, wait, why would you do any of those things? Like, he asked the question the audience wanted to know.
And of course.
You know what I will say? It's really funny, because originally that wasn't in the script, and constantly these guys ask things like, whether it's Seth asking or Peter asking or Martin or anybody saying, this isn't true to my character, I would address this. Like, I would say, Dad, why would you do those things? You know,
Peter
to say, I wouldn't really do these things unless he validates it with, I'm a different person when I leave this apartment. You know, so I love that they try to keep it true. They respect their craft, and I think it comes across. You know, it's these subtle things that they do that, for example, there's a scene later on in the episode where Giovanni and I are kind of fighting.
Mm-hmm. I wrote down fighting with like exclamations.
But, and it started out as first, it was, the director was telling me a little, we were going at it and we were kind of angry. And I said, I don't know that, I mean, I married this man and I love this man, and you don't get there sometimes. You do sometimes, but you know what I mean? There's a way that you bicker and that you fight, but it's still like, all right, dude. All
right. Right.
Come on now.
Yeah. Like, you know, the end goal is going to result.
Yeah.
We like have to live together. You're coming home. We have kids. Let's get it together.
That's the first thing you said when you walked in. You're like, okay, so how long are you going to be weird like this? Yeah. Or whatever the line was.
But. Right. But, and that was the third take, because the first one was, oh, what are you doing here? And they're like, I told them, I said, I feel like I wouldn't be this angry. We should have this relationship. You know, we're married with 2 kids, and for whatever the reason, we love each other.
That's a smart choice.
Do you think that your own relationship, having kids, all that has
absolutely
played into that?
That's probably the number one reason why I've been able to transition into acting, is because my character, Camila, is the mother of our children and the wife to my husband who acts like a child. And I feel like I'm the rock of our family. And in real life, I am the wife to a man who's turning 40 this Saturday, who acts like a child.
Don't you have the same birthday?
We have the same birthday. We do. He acts like a child. He dresses like a fraternity boy. Right? Does he not? He wears Timberlands and like t-shirts.
He does, but he
and Air Force Ones and backwards hats.
He does, but he's also very
okay. Jay-Z wears that as well, and he's 43. Okay, so that validates the baggy
Jay-Z
clothes.
Well, if Jay-Z does it,
yes.
Well, then everybody.
Exactly,
it's true.
No, yeah. But I get what you're saying. Nick is a child.
He's a child at heart, and as is Giovanni, yeah. And I'm the mother, and I am in it. So it is I pull a lot of parallels, and I said to them, I wouldn't yell at Nick this way. I'd be like, come on.
That's what I wanted to ask you too, and this is we're jumping all over the board, but whatever.
That's okay. There's no structure here.
There's no structure.
What is this for?
Wait, yeah. I have a question. Am I the first guest panel?
Yes.
That's Seth.
That's right.
He had to sit there on the couch with the.
But he only had to sit there because he couldn't fit up on these chairs right here. So that's why we had to sit down.
Ouch! Oh, wait, you mean because you had somebody else here or because he really.
No, because there was just us.
We didn't have a booster seat to get him up. So that's why we had to put him down there.
I did not say that. I did not say that.
Seth, you know I love you, man. All right?
It's not me.
Aww.
I wanted to ask you because I know as an actress, you need to find something real to come from, and you're very natural and organic. And I want to ask you, are there any similarities that you can find between Giovanni and Nick that make you
other than the child at heart?
AfterBuzz exclusive.
You heard
Vanessa
it
Vanessa Lachey.
You heard it here
first. It's funny, we actually have something that says that. Yeah.
AfterBuzz TV exclusive.
It's nowhere near as awesome as yours.
We should
re-record
her voice use that next time, Phil.
You know what's really funny is it's not so much about an actual similarity, but it's about finding characteristics in the person that make you like respect and attracted. Yeah. And like after watching the Heck of a Brownie episode, you guys remember
so
that episode
good.
Where
yes.
they, all yeah. the guys ate pot brownies? This is really favorite. Funny, and I don't know what this says about my character. And I don't mean my character Camila. I mean my character as a person, as a human being, as Vanessa Lachey. But after watching Giovanni in that episode, they had to pre-tape the stoner scenes. And I remember sitting on the ground because on live tape night, when we have a pre-tape segment, we just watch it live, literally sitting on the ground on the set. And I was like, Giovanni.
Holla.
He was just going for it. He was totally in the element. He was totally dedicating himself. He had no inhibitions. He threw him, literally like jumped in head first, didn't look. I respect him as an actor, as a father, as a husband, as my husband on TV. There's so many qualities about him that make me love him as a person that I can find that when I'm acting with him.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I can see that. Yeah.
It's like, it's not, I don't know how else to say, it's not a lustful thing because I am such a one man girl and I'm so in love with my husband that it's kind of disgusting.
Aww.
I love him so much that I hate him. That I literally, but like,
that's beautiful in a weird way.
I know.
I think, was it Chris Rock that was like, you don't love a, you don't love a woman until you want to kill her.
Yeah, that's right.
And I love him so much that I'm like, God, I just want to shake the crap out of you sometimes because I love you. So it's not about that with Giovanni. It's just I have so much respect for him that I look to him like a husband, like a father figure, like my best friend would be. You know what I mean?
Right. No, which makes it the more authentic when you guys are
absolutely.
Playing.
And
you
that, and it shows,
exactly.
I think. It shows when
and I
watching.
Would you would see it on my sleeve. If he was just a complete a-hole, I'd be like, oh. And I wear my emotions on my face.
Yes.
I mean, ask Lauren. If something happens and I don't like it, I'm like, what's wrong? Nothing. What's wrong?
So obvious. Which is also what makes you great at the same time, because when we're watching a scene and there's, you know, you're just reacting sort of off on the sidelines, your face is so expressive. You've got the eyebrow going. You've got the
I have to work on it,
going.
Though.
No.
No, so it, sometimes it's
we
too
like
big.
It.
It's too big. I it's fine. I know.
No, we like it.
It's good for MTV. It's not good for Fox.
You're transitioning. I don't think it's bad, but you're transitioning. Everyone
has somebody said this to you, and should we like
no the editor.
No, you know what? I was actually talking to the editor and he was like, Vanessa, if we were to wow, this is way too much information. Exclusive on
AfterBuzz TV exclusive.
Thank you.
You should just keep doing
Phil,
it.
Phil, we just need to get one of these where I go. And then you can hit it. Ready, Phil?
AfterBuzz TV exclusive.
Running the show.
So what happened was I was talking with the editor, and he did say, Vanessa, your expressions are so big. We love it because it is a comedy. It is multicam. It is a live audience. He said, and this is where you come from, hosting in front of a live audience. But sometimes when the camera's on you and it's this tight, the less that you react, the better, because it reads everything. And then Peter Riegert, who comes from theater, you guys would appreciate this. He always says 30 years of Stanislavski down the drain whenever he has to do poop jokes. But he said to me, he's like, try doing your eyebrow expression. So I did it and I went. And he goes, now try doing that with moving nothing on your face but just your eyebrow. And I went. And he's like, so much more just Perfect. Came across right there. Because what you're doing is you're letting the audience do the work for you. Instead of me going, what'd you say? I just go like this. And you get, you can interpret how you want what I'm thinking to make it more relatable and to make it more real. And I'm, and these are all little tiny notes that I'm getting every single week that I am just like a sponge soaking in.
Well, there's a saying in film.
Yeah, the more you know.
That the more you know, exactly. Mm-hmm. And thank you for that. Yeah.
Oh my God, were we the Oscars? Did we just get like, did we just get booted off the stage?
No, yeah, like, and
is that the music? Wrap it up.
Like the opera playing at the Academy Awards. But no, there's a saying in film. This is one of the things I had to learn transitioning from theater to film. But they always say less is more.
Less is more.
And well, just with that example right there.
Less. No, but I think that
well, when
really
it comes to eating, yes.
To me, it is.
Calorie intake.
Eating and shopping, yes, less is less. No. Yeah. But with acting, I've learned. And what do you, I mean, seriously, what do you think when I was like this, or if I'm just like, you're like, oh.
No, it's more
caliente.
No, I think it's more interesting for an audience member to wonder what's happening instead of being so obvious about it. But I think that what that says is that your natural instinct is spot on and that you don't need to think that you're in a scene and that you need to act.
Like, I like coming here because you make me feel really good.
No. It's true, though. I'm just saying,
thank
like,
you,
if you need your self-esteem boosted, come
call Lauren.
Somebody just needs to say, stop.
He did say in his defense, I love you, Kirk. He's like, trust your instinct, girl. He's like, your instinct is spot on. But he's helping me with the camera part of it because I never had that with hosting. Right. With hosting, we were kind of like, you guys are covered with three cameras. It's different. Even though it's multicam, you still are aware of your,
right.
You know, your body. Exactly. Yeah. You got to cheat. You can't block. I can't block your shot. I can't block your shot. So it's I'm learning
different.
With that.
It's
and he
different.
Said, just trust your instinct, but just know that your thought comes across the camera. You don't need to overthink it.
All you have to think about is your thought and not how am I going to make this thought look this
right,
way.
Right, right,
it stops at what my thought is,
right.
I think, right?
Right.
And there's a lot of aspiring actors thinking. Watching right now. You're getting some golden nuggets up here.
Wait a minute. Speaking of nuggets, Phil, zero calls.
No, I've been holding it because I have Seth's commercial.
Oh!
If you give me 20 seconds, I could pull
I
that
love
out.
You, yeah. Phil. You're, okay. Love you.
Wait. You mean Seth and Giovanni's commercial. You're going to die.
Go.
Because
what happened was I found this and I go, oh my God, Seth, this commercial. And he said to me, yeah, that's Giovanni. And I went, stop it. I didn't even
I
recognize
didn't
that it
even
was
know?
Giovanni. No.
Wow. Okay.
And then when I look at it,
is.
He has the same mannerisms, Giovanni, as he does today.
Oh, that does
it
not
is,
surprise me.
It's.
Because he is very specific. I love watching Giovanni.
I loved him in Friends.
Oh my God.
In your show.
My
you know what I wanted to do?
With my check
out that dream I had.
Yeah. And that's Seth, Giovanni.
I get up, I wash my face,
you remember,
and I notice
do you remember
I got
this
a lot
commercial?
More face.
You remember
I'm a guy
this.
On a Kellogg's Fruit Loops box. I'm Toucan Sam. Bad news is, I'm a bird. The good news is, I get all the Fruit Loops I want. Yeah. The faucets even pour oranges, lemons, and cherries. What do you think, Ralph?
Giovanni.
Awesome dream, dude, but you forgot to make them part of this complete breakfast.
Wow, what a dream.
Oh my God.
That was so life-changing.
I just
you're welcome, America.
Inside.
That's you're welcome. Did you see his hair? Giovanni, like,
that's exactly
was that a
what Giovanni
or?
Said. He's like, my hair.
Yeah. What was that?
That's what his hair is. That's how his hair is. Yes.
It
that's
looks
why
so
now.
Justin Timberlake now.
And Justin Timberlake has an afro.
He does. Yeah. I like it.
He's really getting in touch with his black roots. Yeah.
You know how I feel about that, Kevin.
yes, we do.
Okay, we kind of talked about the bed bug thing and how we're going to, you know, and David kind of moves into the office. We're just getting back to this, guys. We're having so much fun.
I know.
Here.
We are. This is like a party. I talk too much.
No, we like it.
Please.
We like it.
Yeah.
So, you know, he's moving into the office. They're trying to find their, and within this, I just need to also touch on this, we're seeing a little
flirtation happen.
Oh, I see where you're going.
Between Brenda's character and Seth's character, Veronica and Eli. And I've had a little feeling about this the entire time, and we're kind of getting a touch of this, but I feel like, you know, this whole bedbugs things happen. It ends up being okay. You know, they get rid of them. It's fine. But what
can't you call services now?
Yeah, there's Edna, I feel like she took care of it. Edna took care of it.
How do you know, though, if you have bed bugs?
Because you know, honey.
You know, you get the bites and then you see them. They're not microscopic.
What do they look like?
All over your body.
You get the bites all over your body and then you actually, you can see the little bugs, right? Look, Google it.
Yeah. I don't know about, like, seeing the bugs makes me nervous. But
you have to throw out your mattress if you get them.
You have to do, like, more than that, I think.
In New York, didn't it go into like movie theaters? Like if someone has bed bugs and then comes to your house, you can get bed bugs.
Yeah. So it's like
it's like fleas. It's like they just spread like
it's like wildfire.
So this is my nightmare.
And now there's like I saw on the news last week, there's like a maniac bed bug that's immune to certain.
Oh, it came through Texas or
this?
Something. Yeah, of course
it came through Texas. Of course.
Everything's bigger in Texas.
Everything's bigger.
Yes, even the bed bugs. But yes.
I don't like that.
No, yeah. Some new.
It's like a superhero bed bug.
Exactly.
It's like the cockroach of the bed bugs. Somebody stop that from happening before it gets to California because that freaks me out.
This is actually my nightmare. I have chills and I want to go home and hide.
We're going to be fine. Really There's upset. No bed bugs here at AfterBuzz TV, so we're good.
At least we think.
We don't know that.
The highlight
there are
of
dogs
this
everywhere.
Episode. There are, but there's no bed bugs.
They have other bugs.
Dogs don't carry bed bugs.
No. They carry fleas.
They carry fleas.
No, not these dogs. Yes. Not these dogs. Okay, so the highlight of this episode for me was...
I love that Lauren's like the mom on set. She's trying to keep it all together us and like really
and
bring
us along.
And
the kids are just acting rambunctious.
Yeah, yes. Okay, sorry.
Guys, we're out of control.
Sorry.
Guys, simmer. No.
Lauren keeps us in check.
I want to talk about how excited I am about all the funny theater jokes that happened in the beginning of the episode.
Oh,
with the
good.
Steering wheel.
And then you did it.
Well, you guys are... Okay, first of all, I have to say this. I didn't know my accent sounded the way that it did until I saw the episode.
What accent?
I thought my
accent
sounded... My southern.
Oh.
Dear Casper. Rat so bastard good. Casper. I thought it sounded... I tried to make it like a bad southern because there is a really good Scarlett O'Hara southern accent. And I thought I was making it bad southern. And Nick said, Vanessa, you sound like an old woman sitting on the porch drinking her sweet tea accent. And I was like, no, I don't. And so when I saw the episode, I miss Alfred something fierce. I was like,
that was so good.
I sound like an old woman sitting on the porch.
But it was
I thought of like Beyonce at that moment. I don't know. The fierce and the accent. I was like, Beyonce.
That's funny
because I pictured Aunt Jemima. So
Aunt Jemima.
Oh wait, Kevin.
You know
did
what
you mean. Just say Aunt Jemima? I have to You put Seth Green on blast. I'm putting you on blast.
Yeah, you're putting me on blast.
You don't
now?
Know Aunt Jemima?
Come on.
Aunt Jemima. Well, I was remixing.
It's not potato, potato. It's Aunt Jemima.
You know what? Okay, first of all,
you can't remix Jemima. Where's Jemima?
Okay, look, Aunt Jemima police over here.
Oh,
okay,
the estrogen is totally attacking Kevin.
It really is.
You're alone.
And I'm kind of intimidated right now, but in a funny way. But no, Aunt Jemima.
Means Aunt Jemima. Okay.
If you can tweet or call in and give us the correct pronunciation of it, I would.
We're telling you, it's Jemima.
I don't know if I believe you guys.
What do you do?
Anyway.
Whatever, Jemima. Mama.
Not potato, potato still.
No, not the same.
But yes, that I felt very Aunt Jemima as well. I felt.
No. Did you feel more Jemima or Jemama?
You know what? I'm leaving this.
Bye, Kevin.
No, Kevin.
I thought that the accent was funny, and it did sound like you were pushing and making it like the theatrical southern accent.
I mean, you did then make out with your husband's dad.
What's crazy is
how
we made out so much.
Talk about it.
For so long.
I can't.
That,
for 4 hours.
No, honestly, I'm really bummed at how much was cut because I was so proud of it. I'm like, I did it.
You made it through.
We did it. We did it together.
Are there bloopers somewhere?
There has to be. And they didn't air. It was just the one kiss, and then they went to Giovanni, and then they came back. And I was already on his lap.
Yeah.
Okay, and when I was on his lap, we were still kissing.
You were? I was going to ask you that. Were you really still kissing?
And it's funny because when you kiss on TV, whenever you're doing an emotional scene, it's like, the music
yeah. Exactly. Slow. It's very and romantic.
It's no,
yes.
It's no tongue. Of course. It's just lips.
Well,
and then you
hope it's not because sometimes they do.
Well,
slip
you notice that unless like
that's
yeah,
for softcore movies, yeah,
method mm-hmm. actors.
Or sometimes in a scene in acting class, you get the tongue slipped in your mouth, oh, and you're like, why is
wow.
that?
Wow.
I just have to. I don't. I'm not saying I did it. I'm saying it happened to me, and you can't stop until you're stopped. So you just have to go with it.
Oh, he totally went for it.
I'm sorry, Lauren. I thought I kept it in my mouth that time.
But my point in telling you this is, and I'm not saying, let me set the record straight. This is not an Phil.
AfterBuzz TV exclusive.
Martin Mull might have slipped me the tongue.
Whoa.
But I slipped it back.
Stop. Whoa.
And I'll tell you why. I'll tell you why. Because we were so into the cheesiness of it, we actually, there was a scene where we were holding each other's faces and we were like, blah, 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 blah. And they didn't use that take. It was so obnoxious
oh my
kissing.
God. I wish they did.
And he was such a sport because I was sick.
Oh,
I'm sure he was.
Yeah, he took one for the team that time. Yeah.
And it's really cute. Nick was on set, literally standing on set, giving Martin Mull the thumbs up. He was like this.
Nick endorsed it.
It was so cute.
Now, I'm curious. Did you guys at all rehearse that kiss? Or
I
is
love
that the
you,
first?
Martin.
You were going to say Nick.
I do love Nick, I love me some Martin Mull.
No, he seems like such a sweet guy.
He's a sweet guy.
And a great kisser.
And he's a great kisser.
Yeah. Yeah, was it? Did you guys rehearse, or was that the first time?
Because I was sick and I was on serious antibiotics and meds that we were waiting, and they're like, "All right, we're going to the scene." I was like, "Martin, you ready?" And we were like high school kids. We were popping mints and gum. He had a pack of gum. I had a pack of mints, and we're like, "You ready?" It was
what a pro right here, right? To just go for it. Yeah. I thought it was super funny. We all, I was involved in the theater, so the jokes really hit home for me. I loved the like fake steering wheel and drinking out of the cup that's empty and the stupid Southern accent. It felt like I was back in high school doing
what do you
and
mean,
the thunderstorm.
What do you mean stupid Southern accent?
The thunderstorm, yes. That was
the thunderstorm. Oh, the thunderstorm. Yeah. I mean, it was just spot on perfect. Yeah. I loved that, you know, everyone kind of went for it and brought that to light. Like it's just
I love
funny.
That he
it's
said
true.
The big cup of nothing. I'm gonna go the drink my big cup of nothing.
I love that he had the mailman come down the aisle way and he's like letter had the full outfit on the full carrier and everything but had no letter. Yeah, it was a letter.
No letter.
And then he gave it letter. To Giovanni and he's like, I will
punch you. Just ask Jesus.
That's funny.
The funniest thing, I guess not to be too analytical on it, but was where the guy came out, the director, I guess, of the show or whoever came out. Like, you know, we can't do it today, Zalid. And the fact that just, you know, they randomly, like in real life, that would happen where someone just comes up and fills in the role
right.
the day of that's never there when you've been rehearsing this
right.
for a period of time. Sorry, I just thought that part
well,
was funny.
Well, because it was such bad community theater. There's no,
right.
there's no, what's it called? There's a name for it. I can't even think right now.
Like not off,
educational
off,
theater?
No, understudy.
Oh, yeah.
There's no understudy because it's
such
a
bad.
And someone from the audience
well,
just comes
you also,
in.
You also thought at that point he was going to say, you know, like they say, the show
must
go on.
Yes.
And then he was like
wait a minute,
canceled.
You guys all got the joke.
Yes.
Yay!
Well, hello.
Hands to the writers.
Yes, right.
Oh, they'll be happy. Yeah.
And then we see your
we got
head
it.
Pop through.
Yeah.
And that was hilarious. And you know the whole scenes that you and Martin did were fantastic. And Giovanni's reaction where he stood up and he was freaked out. And then okay, so then we get to the party, and the fight that you guys had was
hysterical.
I'm like
grabbing a paper. I'm sorry.
Please,
you know, you're trying to look at his notes. It's fine.
Exactly.
You don't have to cheat. We like what you're saying.
And that was weird. That was really weird. I was just like grabbing your paper.
I have a lot of notes if you want.
It's
some
fine.
Of mine.
I have papers. You can touch papers.
We have pictures of you over here too. If you...
So we see that, you know, you come in. You're like, I'm so you in your mind. Camilla's. She's just like, I just did this show. It's amazing. And Giovanni, you can see like the tears welling up in his eyes.
Yeah, he's incredible.
And he's so upset. Set about the fact that his
I would love to know what he was thinking at that moment.
I know,
and I still don't have the courage to ask yet. Like, gee, what was your motivation?
What are you using,
right now? Because I mean, I know what I'm using. What are you using?
What
What's behind
you,
what those
were,
baby? Huh?
What were you using?
At that moment. Well, no, that wasn't a moment where I needed to use something. I'm okay, saying like whenever I
when
need
you're,
to.
Yeah, you know what you're
I mean,
using.
Yeah, for each moment, like if there's a moment where I was fighting, that one was a Nick moment. You know what I mean? When we had the fight scene, I was thinking I wouldn't. That's why I said I wouldn't say this to Nick this way. Yeah. At least, and even the party when he started fighting at me, with me, actually, to your point, I was using that I would be embarrassed. So I kind of was course. Like.
And that was obvious that you were like trying to like,
because if you
we
have a party and your husband's like, you made out with my dad. You're like,
by the way, this girl throws amazing parties. So that is very true to her. Like, no matter what's happening, she's like, everybody's, she, like, the party must go on.
Do
like,
we have good wine? Is the wine cold enough?
No, she's. So that,
well, now that we know each other, we'll get invitations to the next one, right?
That, you know,
right.
That
right.
makes sense.
It's in the
Camila,
mouth.
But it also makes sense for your character. She's a stay-at-home mom. She likes to do stuff like that. Mm-hmm. This is her
Keep
thing.
Keep busy.
Yeah. And this is her one thing that she said, okay, I'm home all the time. And he's trying to give you, oh, I'll give you more money. I love when they make jokes like that. What was the most recent one about where he said, you said, can you get him out of my house? And he said, your
house?
Yeah.
And
yeah.
I go, what? Nothing.
That was,
love you.
Those little things are so funny to pick up on. I love that little juxtaposition that you guys have. But we saw it here a little bit in the fact that you're trying to go out and be creative, and he let you acting like he let you. And then this is where that fight came in, where you were acting with his father and he was acting like it was okay.
Yeah, and then acting like he was in a play.
Yeah.
And then we see that
what you guys didn't see was the third take.
That was awesome.
In the third take, Edna actually drags him upstairs.
No.
And he's on the landing. Literally, he is grabbing the rails in the wall and he's screaming up she's pulling him by his face with
I could so see that
with
too.
Her oh tongue down God. His throat.
Yes.
It was a great take.
Well, wow. You know, we're sorry we missed that, but yeah. See where that would have gone. And
maybe
you
we'll
know,
find the uncuts and
know,
show
right?
them or something.
Maybe
exclusive.
One day. Oh wait, I just gotta mention. Oh wait, that
holler.
Was Seth Green. All right, West Coast, new dads on Fox starts now at Brenda Song, at Vanessa Lachey, at Giovanni RBC.
Holla at AfterBuzz TV, Seth Green. Hello. So this all kind of, you know, everything sort of comes to an end. We're in the office and, you know, we realize the bed bugs are gone and Giovanni's character, Warner, comes back in and it's like, I think I might be jumping out of sequence, but I'm talking about the part where he comes in and says, I just had to drop my kids off at school. And he,
you are.
Let's talk about this scene.
Well, that it's funny because, and we are jumping out of sequence, but and I know that obviously the show is an hour show. Is this an hour show?
So it's forever.
It's
coming to an end, but we'll wrap up.
Giovanni and Seth played with that, and that was made up on the spot, and then
the throwing of the things.
Yes, yeah.
That was we were dying.
Thank you.
In there. Oh boy.
Please. Yes. Perfect. Absolutely.
Improv.
Don't take my wine.
Improv. So right as here. You can see here, I don't even know if they can hear me, but she just threw all of my, we're reenacting a scene from
this
dad
is
here.
What.
We talk about it, we do it. Here.
Vanessa is, this is not, we actions speak louder than words on AfterBuzz TV. Vanessa just showed you what happened on the set live in front of the audience with these actors. What happened is that Giovanni walked into this scene.
I feel violated in a way.
And he, but you liked it.
Yes.
I really did.
You'll
but,
live.
Yeah.
It's Jemima.
you know what?
That's all.
You know what?
Giovanni walked into the scene, and the lines were that he was upset that he has to do, you know, all of these things, take care of his kids. Because
he had to do a dirty diaper.
Yes, and he decided that he wanted to push all the stuff around on the desk, and you watch Seth again, just kind of hold it in. And let it,
yeah,
you know.
It was amazing. The honestly, the
that was an improv.
There was a lot of physical
comedy.
Comedic
genius between these guys and the whole cast is just unparalleled. And I think it's literally like, and I know I'm biased,
no,
but I feel like
not.
It's lightning in a bottle. And I'm happy that I'm a part of it, and I'm happy that we got the full pickup.
Yay!
Yes,
season one.
Congratulations. Yay! No, it was so exciting. I loved that. I think that might have been my favorite part.
I also loved when Giovanni said that he was going to thank Eli.
And slapped him.
Slapped him.
Yeah.
Wait, that's
but
what
like
I was just going
to
get.
But like for real,
that slap.
That was hard.
The physical comedy on this show is hysterical
so
to me.
So good. And Seth Green is so good at physical comedy. And Giovanni as well is just
that slap
talented.
Made me like fall out of my seat laughing.
She even wrote in her notes, the slap.
Like all
we were talking about it because Seth was here saying how much he loves physical comedy.
Yeah. He's so good
and
at it.
And we're like, physical comedy. We see it. It's here.
Yeah. And he's so good at it. And he's great. Like, he helps me with certain things with it. Because it's in me. And, like, you'll see next week in the, I believe it's called Double Trouble. Because it's tennis doubles. We play virtual tennis.
Okay.
And it's two teams, me and my partner versus Eli and his partner. I won't say who the partners are. But there's a lot of physical comedy. And there's even slow motion physical comedy.
Wait, stop it. That's too much. I can't handle that.
I know.
Slow motion physical comedy.
The natural music might be in there. Oh. Kevin? Anybody?
Yeah. Dun, 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 dun. That? No?
That's Chariots of Fire. But close. Same feel. Same feel. Same feel.
Well, so does physical comedy allow you to do, like, not less is more, but just more?
I think physical comedy for anybody in show business is extremely endearing and extremely funny, because people look at certain people on television as you know, this actor or actress or this mother or this, you know, porcelain doll. And to see them do something physically funny is just, it's slapstick. It's comedy 101. It's just, you can't, there's a reason that Charlie Chapman made a living on no words and physical comedy, just literally.
I think the first time we felt like we really saw a lot of that, it's a little bit in every episode, but the Pop Brownie episode was like,
when he was in the refrigerator or the freezer,
that was like your favorite part. I mean, how good was that?
I just couldn't.
Great. It's nice to interject those elements. You feel like you're watching a real multicam sitcom, like with reality TV and all the
thank you, Seth MacFarlane,
that are happening these days. They're great. There's a place for it all, but I feel like this is back to, like, the old. I'm just throwing out my favorites, like Friends and Seinfeld. And it's back in that. It makes you feel like it's like comfort food.
Oh my gosh, thank you. Mm-hmm. From your mouth to God's ears. I hope we're along.
No. Hey, yeah.
Hey, wow. I do have to ask. I'm looking on this wall. You have set secrets, predictions.
Yeah, we're getting there. No, we're getting there.
Oh, I'm wondering, like, what are your predictions?
You're responsible for that.
Are we still?
No, we're going to. I'm responsible for the predictions.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think we've talked about this episode. We loved it. We thought you were fantastic.
Thank you, guys.
It was great to see. We've been predicting all season that we want to see more of the girls. Mm-hmm. And we did. Yeah. We felt like we saw Veronica a lot this episode.
Oh, yeah.
And her flirtatious. And, you know, the stuff happening with Eli. And we loved that. And then we saw a lot of Veronica, of Vanessa's character, Camila, and all of the, you know, wants and needs that she has. And we love seeing that in the fights and the emotion. And it was great
the fight
and natural.
Was hilarious.
So we loved it, and we hope to see more. And
speaking of fighting, next week we actually go to counseling, and we're not allowed to use words. That's all I'm going to say.
Okay.
Ooh. Whoa.
Well, why don't we?
So a lot of this and a lot of physical.
We're moving into predictions.
Now,
we're just doing
your
it right
now. AfterBuzz TV.
Whoa. Oh wait, you have lights there.
Yeah. No, it's like it's
go
we
off.
Have the whole. We have Casper that comes out too behind us.
What? Okay. So
Casper, you rat bastard, Master Casper.
Wait. Do you remember?
Don't make me.
Can you re-say the line that was like super crazy? That
Casper. You're a rat bastard, bastard Casper. That's a hard line I'm going to have to learn.
Yeah, that
was that the line?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
I was overacting, wasn't I?
No, I know. It was good. It was perfect. It was perfect for community theater.
I felt it.
Okay, so we're in predictions. I predict, I'm sorry, this is maybe obvious, but I'm just going to say it. Eli and Veronica are going to have a thing.
Ooh.
Okay? That's my prediction.
Okay.
Would you like to just give a little?
I
can piggyback if you want.
You know, it's funny. I was going to say, I would predict that there's going to be a romance between, but I don't want to just say the same thing you said because sounds redundant and
it's a really good
prediction. Come up with my own prediction.
It's fine.
So I'm going to say that I think that Crawford is going to date somebody.
Ooh.
And bring a date home that causes
no.
Okay,
then we get him out of the house. Like, he gets a date that
he
has her own
date,
place, right?
Gets her own place, goes over there, and it doesn't work out, and he's right back home.
they think they're out, and then they're not.
Good one.
Jen. I will say that I am super, like, biased to the episode I saw, so I, like, keep wanting to predict what I've already seen, and I'm like, why do I have this thought that, like, something's gonna happen with the two dads, and they're just gonna go somewhere else? So I won't say that at all. But when is that episode? When do we see that episode?
Not next week. I think it's the week after. So 2 weeks. You'll see the episode that you were there for the filming.
Great. So I'll make that prediction
Vanessa
next week,
could,
and then I'll be right.
Vanessa could predict, but she also could tease if she wants.
Well, to be honest, I get the script every Tuesday night, the same, and we do the read-through Wednesday. So us as the cast, it's like a present. We're all like, ooh, what are we doing this week? But I'm like, Martin, we're going to make out. Or, you know, Seth, you and I are together. And me and Veronica joke, we're like, we're in a scene together. So we really have no idea what's coming up, because these are the crazy minds of, again, Ted and Family Guy and The Simpsons, actually. Mike Scully is now part of our team.
And you're on the Simpsons area.
And we're on the Simpsons lot, stage. So it's a good group. But I am hoping in my prediction that maybe Warner and Camila have another kid.
Because you have two, even though we mistaken them for three this episode.
And then maybe that would mean that I can have one.
Yeah. Oh.
Because it would be my character.
Holla. Uh oh.
Wait, wow. Wait a minute, Phil.
I'm about to say, is that a
Phil?
AfterBuzz TV exclusive.
She's not pregnant. She's
but
not.
That was
I'm
not still pregnant. Gonna be a question.
No, but I would wow. I would love to be able to juggle both. And I think that it's absolutely possible. And women are amazing human beings who can not only birth a child, but have a show and be a mother and be a wife and be a friend.
Which is what she does so gracefully every day.
Thank you. Gracefully.
Yes. Yes.
Thank
She's
you.
She's not
going to
say
sweet.
That, but no. She.
But I think it can be done, and I want to give it a shot. So why not?
You're doing it. All right. Well, you know what we're going to do? We're going to move into a little news and gossip real quick.
Okay.
And see what we have.
AfterBuzz TV News.
All right. Well, we know we're just going to keep talking about the fact that Dads has got picked up for a full season, which we're so excited about. Totally deserving. Yay. Yay. Congratulations. Yay! Do you have any set secrets that you want to let us in on? I know we talked about the fact that you do 1, 2, 3 bum
vagina.
Oh, my
vagina. Gosh. We do that before every show. 1, 2, 3 bum vagina. I love that you guys know that.
That's bum amazing. Vagina.
It's our battle cry.
Bum vagina.
It was from
like
the episode, obviously, yeah. with HR. Lady.
Which we loved, by the way.
Seth Green loves to vandalize the set.
I saw those Instagram photos today.
He loves to vandalize the set with the googly eyes. So Brenda and I actually vandalized his toilet.
Vandalized.
Get it? V-A-N-D-A-L-E-Y-E-S. Vandalized.
I love that.
Hashtag what? Oh. We did the toilet because when you're going to do this now. You guys know it. You at home and you guys here. When you lift your toilet, there's the two bumpers. Yeah. So the toilet doesn't slam. Yeah. They look like angry eyebrows. So if you put googly eyes underneath, it's angry eyebrows.
How did you find this out?
There's time.
There's time. There's time in between takes.
Right.
That's probably the most fun that
like
we do
that.
On set.
I love bum vagina and the googly eyes. You can follow them on Instagram. Where can we see you on Instagram?
I'm so boring. I'm at Vanessa Lachey.
Like
my name, VanessaLachey on everything. Brenda's at Brenda Song. Seth is actually...
He gave it to us last time, but his is like
53 CRD.
No, that's on Instagram. He's at Seth Green on
Twitter.
And then I believe it'll link, you know, you can...
Yeah, you can find it and on his website.
And then Giovanni is also there at Giovanni Ribisi.
So follow them all. You can see, you know, all the little happenings because they post stuff that, you know, I've seen the googly eye stuff. If you follow them, it's fun to kind of... But now we get where it's coming from. Okay, well, you know what? We're wrapping up here.
What?
So
that's
much.
It? Guys, I'm leaving?
So much
I could say.
So amazing. So thank you so much for coming in, Vanessa.
Yes. Cheers.
Cheers.
We had a great time. Good.
And we learned a lot about acting.
We did.
We learned so much.
And how to reenact.
All right, hold on.
Did you learn that it's Aunt Jemima?
I've been holding the collars.
Oh.
Let's take one collar.
There were collars? Yay!
I haven't screened him, by the way.
Okay.
He can be somebody's dad.
Hello?
Tell us. I love the random ones.
Hello. Are we here? Do we have a caller?
You're on live.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hi. Thanks for calling AfterBuzz TV. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Dallas, Texas.
Okay. What's your name?
Hey AJ,
thank you for calling.
AJ.
What's up? What do you
Hello.
Do you have a question for Miss Vanessa Lachey?
Hi AJ, it's Vanessa. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good.
What's going on
in Dallas?
Other than bedbugs.
Raining. Gloomy.
So are we just gonna chat? What are you doing?
Nothing. Not much.
No, nothing at all, really. Just got off not too long ago.
Okay.
Got off work?
Mm-hmm.
Where do you work?
At this little call center.
Oh, cute. Hey, do you watch Dads on Fox?
Do I watch what?
My show, Dads, on Fox TV.
No, I don't.
What?
Wait a second. We need to
on the play. Maybe this is why we normally screen callers, right, Phil?
That is 100% the case.
Hey,
why?
So what do you just want to hang out? What's up? You just want to talk?
I mean, I wanted to see if, you know, they were doing the recap for Bad Girls Club.
You did it to us, Bill.
Called it.
Well, you know what? Hey.
Fortunately, this is the dad's. You're talking to Vanessa Lachey right now.
But we got three Bad Girls.
I think you got better than the Bad Girls.
He said, who? Hey, check out Dad's on Fox Tuesdays at 8. And we love you. And they're going to give you, I think Phil's going to actually give you the rundown now on the Bad Girls Club. That's Phil's.
Okay. Yes.
Check it out. You missed it by an hour, brother.
But thank you for calling. And thank you for watching AfterBuzz TV. It was so nice
to talk
to you.
We love you. Thank you.
And all you have to do now is watch Dad's on Fox.
Yeah, Tuesday. AJ, call back next week.
Okay, I'll watch that now.
Thank you. Yay.
And go Cowboys.
And guess what, Phil? You got us. You got us.
No.
You got
us.
thank you for calling. Have a good week.
Peace out. Bye. Be a fan of Dad's.
I knew that, but that always happens to us.
Yeah, thanks. I can't wait to come back, Phil.
Seriously, Phil. Okay, you guys, thank you so much for tuning in and listening and watching. By the way, if you're on iTunes and you're looking up whatever we're all talking about, please rate and comment, tell a friend, keep the conversation going. That's what we're here for.
Five stars.
We talk about the shows that we love, and we want to hear what you guys love, too. So please talk about us. Five stars. Look at us all. Okay, and you can find me. I'm your host, Lauren Leonelli. You can find me at Lauren Leonelli on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Vine, and my website.
I'm Kevin John. You can find me on Twitter at HeyKevinJohn, Instagram at HeyKevinJohn, and on my website, www.itskevinjohn.com.
And I'm Jennifer Golden. You can find me on Instagram and Twitter at JenTheJew. Yes, JenTheJew.
Ooh. And I'm Vanessa Lachey. You can find me Tuesday nights at 8 on Dad's on
That's
Fox.
Right. Tune in. Thank
Doing that voice.
Thank you so much, you
Fox,
guys.
Fox, Fox,
bringing you all the guests we can. We will see you guys like next week. Holla.
From executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later!
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.